kids, welcome back to our series called Christmas Stars. We are learning some incredible lessons from the stars of the very first Christmas. Each character teaches us an important truth. But before we get to that truth today, I have something I want you to answer. I want you to imagine something with me first. Imagine there's a new king about to be born. This isn't any king though. This is the most important king that has ever been born. His arrival is going to change the world in ways that no one, and I mean no one, could ever imagine. So here's that question. If you were in charge of inviting the guest to witness the birth of this amazing king, who would you invite? The president? Kings of other countries? Famous movie stars? Your favorite basketball player or football player? The richest people you know that could give a good gift? Who? Well, we're going to learn who was invited when Jesus, the King of Kings, was born. Because you know, when he was born, it changed everything. But first, let's check out this video.
Sheep are in their pen. If they got out, that would be very bad. Oh, come on. You know that was a funny joke. Oh, hi there. It's me, your old friend, Holly. Hollywood. You remember, future movie director. But right now, I'm working in the community theater, directing a stage play all about the main characters in the Christmas story. It's called... That's right, it's called Christmas Stars. That's my stage manager. She loves to interrupt me, and she's usually right. Well, I'm super excited about the scene we're rehearsing later today. It's with the wise men. They came from a long way to bring gifts to Jesus. They were super important people, you know. What do you mean, what about the shepherds? What about them? I mean, they're just plain old shepherds. They weren't wise men. What do you mean they were the first to meet Jesus? Is that true? That can't be true. Jesus was the King of Kings. Surely he wouldn't leave heaven and come to earth and then choose as the first people he would meet a bunch of shepherds in a field? Did he really? Sent an angel choir to invite the shepherds? I really don't know about that. There's only one way to know for sure, and that is to consult the script for this play, the Bible. Let's see here. Yes. Wow, it's true. Jesus chose to come to earth not just for the important people like the wise men, but he also came for the not so important people like the shepherds. That is exactly what I was going to say. Jesus came for everyone. You're going to learn all about the wise men and the shepherds in your lesson today. You're going to learn that no matter who you are, Jesus loves you and has a plan for your life. You're right. Christmas is for everyone. So, I guess I better let you get to it. My name is Hollywood, and I'll see you next time as we learn from another one of the Christmas stars. Bye-bye. Cut!
I'm excited to learn more about the kind of people who were invited to the birth of Jesus in our lesson today. I think you'll be surprised at what we can learn from who was there at that very first Christmas. Right now, it's time to find out what you gotta know.
Cool cats, it's me, Peggy Sue, and I'm here to tell you guys what you gotta know. Today, we're learning that Jesus came for everyone. So, every time today someone asks you what you gotta know, you tell them, joy to the world, the Lord has come.
I'm so glad Jesus came for the important people. They've got it made in the shade. Well, he did come for the important people, but that's not all. Righto. He also came for the dweebs, the squares, the nerds, the goofs, you know, the not so important people too. Yikes. That's one way to put it. Oh, for sure. See, Jesus came for everyone in the whole world. Isn't that nifty? You betcha. Jesus came to save everyone from their sins. So, every time today someone asks you, what you gotta know? You tell them, joy to the world, the Lord has come. And that is what you gotta know. I'm Peggy Sue saying, see you later, alligator.
It's my favorite restaurant, especially during Christmas time. Problem is, I'm always getting things mixed up with people's order, and I'm always getting things mixed up with the Power Verse too. So I'm gonna need your help getting everything unscrambled. Let's take a look at it. And she will have a son, and you are to name him Matthew, for he will save his people from their sins. 121 Jesus? See, I told y'all it was mixed up. Kind of like the time I pressed the wrong buttons on the cash register and someone's order came out as a chimney change purse instead of a chimichanga. And the change purse was full of quarters, so it came out of my paycheck. Wasn't good, and it ain't funny. I gotta stop mixing stuff up, especially the Power Verse. Y'all help me get this thing straightened out. Here we go. She will have a son, and you are to name him Matthew, for he will save his people from their sins. Hold up! Wait a minute. Matthew didn't save people from their sins. What should we do about this? Yep, we need to move Matthew over to the side. Now, where's this verse found? 121 Jesus? Yikes! That's wrong for sure. First of all, the numbers go at the end of the scripture reference. Should we swap them around? Good idea! But even still, it ain't right. Is Jesus a book of the Bible? Nope. Let's move Jesus to the only blank we have left in the verse. Now, all we need is the book of the Bible. What should we put there? Yep, Matthew. Woo, that's it. That's the whole enchilada. Let's try saying it all together on the count of three. 1, 2, 3. And she will have a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. Matthew 1:21. Hot dog! Now, we gotta make sure we can remember it so we don't mix it up in our brains later on. Let's read it one more time together on the count of three. Y'all stand up and say it with me real loud. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. And she will have a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. Matthew 1:21. Great job, boys and girls. Now, I have got to get back to the register. We just added a hot new menu item for the Christmas season. Tree topper taquitos, star-shaped or angel-shaped, whichever you prefer. It's gonna be a good time, so get you some. This is Carl from Taco Bill saying, bye-bye, y'all!
Today's Bible lesson is one that's filled with great surprises from Matthew 2, verses 1 through 18. There are so many Christmas songs that are written about this part of the Christmas story. It all starts with a group of shepherds taking care of sheep out in the middle of a field late at night. As you can imagine, they were probably bored as can be. This was something that they did a lot. Taking care of sheep could be quite boring in my opinion, but I've never taken care of sheep, but if I had to guess, it's very boring. But anyhow, their lives were about to change. They were gonna get a huge surprise. Check this out. Suddenly, up in the sky appeared a group of angels. can you believe it? A group. They spoke to the shepherds and they said, "Do not be afraid. We bring you good news that'll bring great joy to all people." The shepherds were amazed by what they saw. Then the angels began to sing, "Glory to God in the highest." They told the shepherds all about baby Jesus who had been born in Bethlehem. This baby, Jesus, was the Son of God who had come to earth to take away the sins of all people. Then, just as quickly as the angels had appeared, they disappeared. They were gone. The shepherds didn't know what to make of this. They all looked at each other, they looked around, they said, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened." They ran as fast as they could until they reached the town of Bethlehem. The shepherds went straight to the stable where Mary and Joseph were. Mary and Joseph stayed in the stable because there was no room in the inn. After all, the city was full of people because every single person had traveled there in order to pay their taxes. The shepherds were the surprise guests at Jesus' birth. They gathered all around Jesus, the Savior of the world, and worshiped him. The shepherds learned that day that Jesus came for all people. The angels appeared not to the most important people of that time, but to regular, ordinary shepherds. They showed the world that God sent his Son into the world to save the whole world from their sins. In our lesson today, you are going to learn that God doesn't see people as important or not important. He sees all people the same, and he sent his Son Jesus to save everyone from their sins. What an incredible Christmas gift.
The story of Christmas, Jesus and the shepherds. This is Jesus.
Hoo-yah!
Jesus is the Son of God who would grow up to do amazing things. His parents on earth were Mary.
Hi!
And Joseph.
Heyo.
Jesus was born in a barn because there was no room for him anywhere else in Bethlehem. On the night Jesus was born, there were some shepherds in the field keeping watch over their sheep. Suddenly, an angel appeared before them. And a bright light shone all around them. The shepherds were so scared, but the angel said, "Don't be afraid.
Okay.
I bring you good news that will bring great joy to all people. The Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord, has been born today in Bethlehem, the city of David."
Whoa, what?
The angel told the shepherds that they would find Jesus in a barn, wrapped in strips of cloth, laying in a manger.
Okay.
Then the angel was joined by many, many other angels, and all of them sang, "Glory to God in highest heaven, and peace on earth to those with whom God is pleased." Then the angels returned to heaven.
What just happened?
And the shepherds said to each other, "Let's go to Bethlehem."
Yeah.
So they hurried to the village.
You stay there.
And found the baby Jesus laying in the manger.
Wow!
After seeing Jesus, the shepherds told everyone what had happened and what the angel had told them about the baby Jesus. Everyone who heard the shepherd's story were amazed. Mary made sure she remembered all these things and thought about them often. Then the shepherds went back to their sheep and praised God for all they had seen. The baby was exactly who the angel had told them he was, the Savior of the world, the Son of God.
Today we are learning a very important part of the Christmas story, and it's something that many people find difficult to understand because it goes against the way human beings naturally think. We tend to think that people are on levels. If you're famous or you have a lot of money or you're the boss of lots of people, you're on a higher level than others. You know, you are very important. And of course, if you're poor, sometimes you are viewed by others as being on a lower level than others. And we often refer to those kinds of people as not so important people. And we treat them according to what level we think they're on. If someone is important, we look up to them and we want to hang out around them as much as possible. And if someone is not so important, we tend to ignore them and not pay as much attention to them. But that's not the way Jesus thinks.
That certainly is not the way God looks at people when he chooses to send his son, Jesus, into the world as tiny baby Jesus. And you see,
Jesus came for the important people. Remember the wise men in the Christmas story? They were very definitely important people. They had crowns like this. They were scholars from a far away land. In the Christmas songs, they were called Three Kings, as in we three kings. They had a lot of money. They brought very expensive gifts to Jesus all the way from their faraway lands. We know that Jesus came for important people like the three kings. That makes sense to us because the wise men were on a higher level than many other people. They had much more money and fame and power than most. Of course, Jesus came to earth to save those important people and many others like them. But important people are not the only people Jesus came for.
Jesus also came for the not so important people. Remember the shepherds in today's part of the Christmas story? The shepherds definitely were not considered important. Nobody paid any attention to the shepherds. They were all alone out in the fields in the middle of the night. Nobody thought much about the shepherds. They were average, they were ordinary, they smelled like sheep, and I mean, you can't get any more not so important than that. But God paid special attention to these not so important shepherds. God sent an entire choir of angels to give the first invitation to come see Jesus, who had just been born. The shepherds got the word even before the wise men did. They were the first to arrive at Jesus' birth to worship him. Isn't that awesome? Even though other people didn't think they were worth much, God knew that the shepherds were very important in his eyes. What does this teach us? It teaches us that whether you are rich, famous, and important, or you are poor, unknown, and not so important in the eyes of others, God loves all people the same. He sent Jesus for the important and the not so important. It doesn't matter what others say about you. God says you're worth him sending his son to earth to save your sins. In fact,
Jesus came to save all people from their sins. Every person in the world means the same to God. Jesus came so every single person could have the opportunity to be saved from their sins. Whether it is a prince in Europe or a poor child in Africa, God loves them all the same. Whether it's in general, across the sea, somewhere in Asia, somewhere in South America, Jesus came for everyone. During this Christmas season, let's remember that God loves all people just the same. Don't think that you don't deserve as much as someone else. Don't think that important people deserve Jesus's love and you don't. Jesus's love is for you. It's the most important thing, and he came to save us, came for you to feel his love. So let's celebrate the fact that Jesus loves everyone.
And she will have a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. Matthew 1:21.
Welcome to the Rewind Review. I am here today with Miss Monique. Woo. And Mr. Devante, and I am Miss Danielle, your host today. So we are gonna get ready and do our questions. So I wanna hear you guys saying them too. If you get them before them, I wanna hear you say them and just play along with us. Okay, are you guys ready? Are you guys ready?
Yeah, so ready.
All right, let's get into our first question. Witches, what you gotta know today?
Joy to the world, the Lord has come.
Oh. Yes, exactly.
One of my favorite Christmas songs, so it's hard to forget that one.
Yeah, I really like that one. Okay, now we're gonna go on our next one. Where were the shepherds at the beginning of our Bible story today?
In the fields.
Yes, that is correct, in the fields.
Ooh.
Okay, next one. What appeared suddenly to the shepherds while they watched their sheep?
An angel.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, was it just one angel,
though? It was multiple.
Yes, it was a chorus of
chorus.
Angels.
Chorus. Mm-hmm. Of angels.
Which means at least more than one.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Okay. Who did the angels say had been born?
Their new king, the Son of God.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus.
Yes, exactly. Jesus was born. Okay, were the shepherds allowed to visit the baby Jesus?
Yes.
Yes, they were. They went before the wise men.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Okay, now, according to our lesson today, Jesus came for the blank people.
The ordinary people?
No, not quite. The first one is not ordinary.
The rich people or the wealthy?
Yes, you pretty much got it. The important people. Yeah, Mr. Yeah. Devante got it. We'll give him the point. All right, next one. Same type. It's fill in the blanks. Jesus also came for the blank people.
The ordinary people.
Yes, the not so important
people. The peasants.
So God came for the important and the not so important. He came for everyone.
Yes.
All right, next one. Same type. Jesus came to save blank people from our sins or their sins.
All people.
Yep, that's pretty much what we just said. Yes. It's from all people.
All people.
All right, now, next one is, does God love everyone the same?
Yes, he does.
Mm-hmm.
Of course.
Yep, God loves everyone the same. All right, we're almost done. This is our last question, okay? So let's see. Where was our power verse found?
John, Matthew, Luke. Matthew.
Matthew
5:11.
Matthew 1:21.
Yes, woo! I think
teamwork.
Well, yes, I think Ms. Monique got it, and I bet you guys got it before they even did.
Right.
So great job. I'm so glad you guys were here with us to do this rerun review, and we will see you next time. Bye.
Bye.
Thank you so much for watching our series called Christmas Star. We talked about the shepherds and how they were important, but they were important because everybody's important in God's eyes. Thank you for watching once again, and we will see you next time.